Hello, my dear children of class 6. I hope you all are fine. And as you remember, we are discussing the 6th chapter of your physics. The name of the chapter is what? Magnetism. In the first part, we have discussed what are magnets, what magnetism is, and few properties of magnets. In this part, we are going to discuss magnetic field around a magnet, permanent and temporary magnets, and various uses of those magnets, care and storage of magnets, and finally, demagnetization by heating, hammering, or passing electricity. So, let's see what magnetic field is around a magnet. Now, wherever a magnet is kept, the space around a magnet in which if a magnetic substance such as any small piece of iron, cobalt, or nickel are placed, they feel the attraction force towards the magnet. And this area or this space is known as magnetic field, right? I know whenever you all used to play with magnets, like sometimes you used to bring one piece of iron near to the magnet. After crossing a certain area, you feel the attraction force, but beyond that area, you do not feel the attraction force, right? So the certain space where the magnetic attraction force is experienced, that certain space is known as the magnetic field around that magnet. So at each place, in absence of any magnet, the needle of a magnetic compass always rests in geographic north-south direction. In the first part also, we have discussed that. But suppose if any magnetic compass is placed near any other magnet, then the needle will swing and it will rest into some other direction. As the position of magnetic compass is changed, the direction in which its needle rests also changes. Okay. So what we are saying here, when like any magnet is brought near to any like magnetic needle, and if it swings, then it will rest in some other direction. Because generally we know, because of the magnetic field of the earth, it rests in north and south direction. But if any other magnet is also brought, then it may rest in some other direction. Okay. Now, like how will we understand, how will we recognize the magnetic field around a magnet? Okay. Suppose for this thing, you need some iron filings. Okay. And iron filings means what? Like very tiny particles of iron. So you take iron filings on some sheet of stiff paper and spread that iron filings nicely on that. Then on tapping the sheet gently, the iron filings are found arrange themselves in a definite pattern if one magnet is placed below that sheet. Suppose you are taking the iron filings over the stiff sheet of paper, and if you place a bar magnet under that like paper, then what will happen? In the diagram, you can see a pattern, one carved pattern is seen. So iron filings will be arranged in that pattern. So later on you will be studying about like force line of magnets. So like in what way the magnetic iron filings are like arranged, in that way we can understand that the magnetic field is how much. So after a certain space, you will not find the iron pieces are being arranged. So that is why, like by this experiment, we can understand the how much the magnetic field is there around any magnet. In the second stanza, what is written? The pattern of the iron filings represent the magnetic field of the magnet. The pattern will represent the magnetic field around the magnet. Its direction from North Pole to South Pole, you can see curved lines are there starting from North Pole and ending at South Pole. And the magnetic field is not at all uniform. It is not similar throughout the magnetic field or throughout the magnet. It is strong near to the magnet while weak at a distance of the magnet. Now you all know very well, the more near you bring the any magnetic substance towards any magnet, more attraction will be experienced. If you take the iron piece far, then less amount of attraction force will be experienced. Now I was telling you about Earth's magnetic field. We know that Earth itself behaves like a magnet, and as it behaves like a magnet, it has a magnetic field also around it. So in a limited space, the magnetic field of the Earth is same everywhere. We can say it is uniform. and its direction is what? From geographical south to geographical north. Okay, now you see the Earth's magnetic field is shown also in the diagram by giving some arrow. Okay, so you can see like from south towards the north, right? Now you can if someone does one activity, like if any person takes a soft iron bar and place it under the earth, under the soil, okay, or under the ground, then after few days, after some days, the piece of iron will also turn into a magnet. Why it happens like that? Okay, the earth has a magnetic field and the earth also behaves like a magnet. So there must be magnetic north pole of the earth at the geographical south and a magnetic south pole in the geographical north pole, right? So in that case, what happens? The iron bar also get magnetized. It also turn into a magnet. And the end which is towards the geographical north becomes the north pole, and the end which is geographical towards the south of the iron bar, that will become the south pole. But that means what? It is opposite to the earth's poles. Okay, so if the earth's magnetic north pole is at the south, then the earth's magnetic south pole will be at the geographical north. I hope you understood this part. If you do not understand, you can always take help from me. Now there is one interesting fact. Though earth behaves as a magnet, there is no magnet inside the earth. That is what is written in the column, do you know? Okay, now let's see what is temporary magnet and what is permanent magnet. A temporary magnet means what? Which is temporary, whose magnetism is not permanent. So what definition we can write? A magnet which soon loses its magnetic properties is called temporary magnet. That means the magnetic properties are not eternal. It is not eternally existing inside the magnet. Like for example, we can say an iron piece in presence of an external magnet becomes a temporary magnet by magnetic induction. Okay, like the way we were saying that if you keep a soft iron bar like inside the earth, that also becomes magnet. But you can do this experiment by yourself also. If you bring any magnet near to any iron iron piece, then that iron bar or iron needle or iron piece also acts like a magnet. Or sometimes like when current is also passed through a coil, then also it acts like a temporary magnet. Okay, and you must remember, a temporary magnet is generally made of soft iron. And what is permanent magnet? The magnet whose magnetism is permanent, whose magnetic properties are permanent, those magnets are known as permanent magnet. So while writing the definition, what we can write, see in the screen, a magnet which does not lose its magnetic properties is called a permanent magnet. It is made up of steel by the electrical method. Okay, so temporary magnet is made up of soft iron and permanent magnet is made of steel. I hope you understood temporary magnet and permanent magnet. Now let's see what are the main differences we must learn between temporary magnet and permanent magnet. Like I said, a temporary magnet is made of soft iron, whereas permanent magnet is made of steel. Then temporary magnet show magnetic properties so long as the current passes in the coil around it, okay, or the coil which is wound around it. Okay, wound means what? Tied. Okay, so as soon as the current stops, the magnetic property also finishes, right? But in case of permanent magnet, it shows magnetic properties even after the current is stopped through the coil around what is wound around it. Okay, then the magnetic strength of the temporary magnet can be changed by increasing the amount of current. The magnetic property can be increased, and by decreasing the flow of current, the magnetic property can be decreased also for temporary magnet. So magnetic properties can be changed. But in case of permanent magnets, the magnetic strength, the magnetic power cannot be changed. Then at the fourth point, we can see that the polarity can be changed of a temporary magnet by reversing the direction of the current. Suppose the current is flowing from flowing in a particular way. If the current starts flowing in some opposite direction, then the previous north pole will become south pole, and the previous south pole will also become north pole. What I am trying to say, when through a wire the current passes, the soft iron bar acts as a magnet. You all understood that. Now, like when the current is passing, there will be a south pole and there will be a north pole. But if the direction of the current changes, okay, then the south pole and north pole will also be interchanged. But in case of permanent magnets, the polarity cannot be changed. Okay, I hope you understood this point very nicely. Then the last point is what? The temporary magnets can be easily demagnetized, where that permanent magnets cannot be easily demagnetized. Now, what is demagnetization, or what is the meaning of demagnetized? Demagnetization, or the meaning of getting demagnetized, that means losing the properties of magnets. So I hope you understood the fifth point as well. Now you must know what are the uses of magnets. Why are we studying magnets? Why magnets are important in our life? You can see temporary electromagnets are used in many electrical and electronic devices, like say electric bells, telephone receivers, loudspeaker, magnetic toys. I hope you all have seen pieces of magnet inside radio, TV, and inside many electrical and electronic equipments, right? Then see at the number 2 point we have written, strong electromagnets are used for loading and unloading scraps of iron. Suppose if any strong magnet is there, so you can easily pull the iron using that strong magnet. Then at 3, we have written, permanent magnets are used in electrical measuring instruments such as galvanometer, ammeter, and voltmeter. Later on in higher classes, you will study more about these devices, and then you will come to know how permanent magnets are used inside them. Then magnets are used in electric motors such as dynamo, speaker, computer, etc. Like I said, inside many electronics devices also magnets can be used, like in motors, dynamos, or speaker. And magnetic compass is also used, I have told you, by the sailors. That means the people who used to go for in the sea with their big ships to understand the direction also, they use the compass, which is also made of magnet. So I hope you understood the uses of magnets very nicely. Now let's see care and storage of magnets. Whenever we use any substance, we must take care of that substance, and we must know how to store a magnet so that its magnetic property cannot be lost, or magnetic property cannot be decreased. So you see here, like we take help of magnetic keepers. Okay, and these magnetic keepers are nothing but the pieces of soft iron. Like in the picture 6.18, you can see two bar magnets are placed with the help of two magnetic keepers. In the blue color, the magnets are shown, and orange color, the magnetic keepers are shown. And you see like a pair of bar magnets A and B, magnet A and magnet B, they are kept with opposite polarities, like under the north pole, the south pole is there, right? And they are kept using the magnetic keepers P and Q. And you must be observing that there is a piece of wood in between the two magnets. Now you must be wondering why this piece of wood is kept as two magnets are placed, there will be attractive and repulsive force acting between them to minimize that, or so that there is no change happens in their magnetic field or magnetic property, the piece of wood is kept. Then you see what I have written, by magnetic induction, opposite polarities are developed at the end of each soft iron piece, and a closed cycle is formed. You can see there is a closed cycle in the picture 6.18. In the soft iron piece, they are not magnets, okay? They are just the soft iron piece. But as they are kept in contact with two magnets, so where the south pole of the magnet A is attached to the side of the Q, there the north pole will be formed, and where the part of the soft iron piece Q is connected to the north pole of magnet B, their south pole will be developed. So that is why we have written, by magnetic induction, opposite polarities are developed at the ends of each soft iron piece, and a closed cycle is formed. So this prevents the loss of magnetism of magnets, and that is the purpose of using magnetic keepers, and that is the purpose of storing magnets with proper care. Now, for bar magnets, you understood we have to keep it using two magnetic keepers. But suppose you have a magnet of some different shape, say a horseshoe magnet, then you need only one soft iron piece. Okay, you can see a horseshoe magnet is looks like U, right? So U has two arms. So if you keep one soft iron piece, that is the magnetic keeper, connecting the two arms of that horseshoe magnet, then it, like this magnet also can be preserved, right? So here also you can see, like where the north pole of the horseshoe magnet is kept, there the south pole is developed, and where the south pole of the horseshoe magnet is kept, there the north pole is developed, right? Then we must understand what are the different ways to demagnetize a magnet. There may be a necessity where you do not want a magnet to sustain its magnetic properties. In that case, a magnet need to be demagnetized. So how a magnet can be demagnetized? And you can see the meaning of demagnetized also written. The meaning of demagnetization is the magnetic properties of a magnet destroying. Okay, destroying of the magnetic properties of a magnet is known as demagnetization. So the question may come, what do you understand by demagnetization? So what your answer will be? Destroying the properties or destroying the magnetic properties of a magnet is known as demagnetization. So demagnetization can be done in various ways. See, by rough handling, if you do not take care of a magnet, the magnetic property will be lost. So in that case, like one magnet can be demagnetized. If you hit a magnet with a hammer, okay, if you hit strongly a magnet, then the magnet loses its magnetic properties. Okay, and in this way also one magnet can be demagnetized. By dropping a magnet repeatedly on a hard surface, okay, either you hit a magnet or you drop a magnet many times, okay, on a hard surface, then also the magnet will lose its magnetic property. If you hit, see the number fourth point, if you hit a magnet, okay, by using fire or by any means, if you give some temperature, okay, high temperature, then also the magnet loses its magnetic property. Okay, so by hitting the magnet to a high temperature also one way of demagnetizing it. Okay, and the last point, you can see, by passing alternate current through a coil around the magnet, keeping it in east and west direction. Okay, so if like one coil is kept in the east and west direction, and if you pass on AC current, that is the alternating current, then also the magnet can be demagnetized. I hope you understood all the parts of this magnetism, and I really want you all to make nice notes of all these like slides what you have seen in front of you. Thank you, children. Till the next chapter, please take care.